Our three erstwhile colleagues. We have Nahaz back on the panel for the first time here at Minimal Magic. Welcome. We also have Toby One, who has done a little bit of commentary this morning as well, I think, a little bit. Okay. Empire-y stuff. And also Fogged, welcome back as well. Good to have you back. You had a good time this morning. Yeah, that was good fun.
Round two.
These guys are going to get into the game fairly quickly. We're already into the draft, so we will get your thoughts as we go through. But we'll bring the draft up as we go along. There's a couple of bands already so far. Nahaz, we'll start with you. Interesting that we've got these two teams in particular in the lower brackets, right? Mm-hmm. It's lucky in many ways that this isn't elimination time for these two teams and that all of them carry on to the lower bracket, regardless of whether they go out now. But did you really expect Wings and Secret to be in the lower bracket game?
Secret, I think, was kind of the high variance team coming into the tournament. A lot of people wondering which version of that team would show up. They definitely had some communication problems in the last couple of events. Wings, though, yeah, I think everybody, a lot of people had Wings top six, if not top four, expected them to have a fairly easy time in this group. And yeah, to see them come out and drop their first series was a major surprise.
Toby, thoughts?
I wasn't actually expecting Team Secret to do that well. I got to watch them on very closely during Epicenter, and a lot of the time it was this... you knew there was a lot of dis-synergy within the team, and I didn't know if they could repair it in time for the middle of Major. I wasn't backing them that much, but Wings, I did not expect them to be in this position. I actually had Wings up there in my top four, top five for this competition.
I think almost everyone
I think
did,
all of us did.
Yeah.
Yeah, we did.
And the fact is that as we go into the draft now... Bounty's first pick. That's a new one so far here. We haven't had that so many times. Saw a little bit last time out at Epicenter, but it has been a popular pick in this particular patch. Because they did so well last time they were here in Manila, a lot of people were saying, well, they're going back home, they're in Manila again, they'll have that vibe, they'll remember how they won, and they should be really hot. And we know how they can play, albeit kind of some strange stuff with support being put in mid and stuff going in the jungle that you don't expect, but we know how good they are, and yet here they are in the lower bracket.
Yeah, definitely shocking to see Wings here, but maybe they went a little bit too outside the box with what they were trying to do, and
I mean, they won
got
that
punished
game.
From it, you
they
know?
Won that
they
game.
Did win that game, that is a good point. But
they did win that game. Okay, Darkseer is Secret's first pick. So no major surprises so far.
Where's the Phoenix?
Apart from the Phoenix, potentially, yeah.
Well, I like the fact, though, that Wings have gone in a different direction with the Bounty Hunter, and they really are. They're looking to punish that very greedy style that Secret plays, where they're trying to farm up two cores very, very heavily, relying on Universe to create a lot of space. I like the Bounty Hunter open. The Nightstalker pick, I'm a little bit dubious on. Death's Hero has really struggled. He's kind of near the bottom in our Elo shift ratings by hero. He hasn't had a lot of success in the offlane role, though Newbie ran him very effectively earlier today.
Mm. I think maybe that's kind of like a deterring, like a counterpick toward the Bounty Hunter, even though,
of course, with the Darkseer.
Yeah. Yeah, and also maybe, I think the Darkseer also kind of may have been a counterpick as well, because, you know, the Bounty Hunter Darkseer, I think Wings is one of the teams that has ran it before, and it Darkseer is one of their popular offlaners. And now we do see the Lifesteer picked up quite early. We haven't been seeing him too much.
No,
it's been a Chinese staple, though, recently. Like, the Lifesteal or Lion Open is kind of the standard open for a lot of these squads, including Newbie. But I'm not surprised that Wings would pair it with the BH.
And it's also, you know, it's a hero that can tolerate the Ion Shell, of course, because you can either Rage or you just attack the creep really quickly, and, you know, Feast works really well against it.
Still, a question for you, though. We saw in at least a couple of the games earlier a Lifestealer really suffer early on. It was actually Resolution's Lifestealer that suffered really badly early on in lane against a Darkseer, because of course you can Rage to prevent some of that damage, but you can't really use Rage to farm the lane against Iron Shell.
As long as they have, like, you need a support there, you know, you need to at least have, I think Wings is usually recognizes that too. They emphasize on securing the short lane, so I think that they will probably have, like, either the Bounty Hunter start there or maybe one of the other supports, if not even, like, have a tri-lane committed, because Secret could run that dual aggro tri-lane, which we do see happen quite often, if they don't opt to go for the Iron Talon jungle puppy. What's up, Toby?
How you doing, buddy?
What's up, man?
Hi.
How you doing, Toby?
I'm doing great. I'm doing fantastic. I want to see more of this draft actually unveil.
Did you enjoy the Drow game earlier?
I actually did. I did. There was a lot of enjoyment behind that one. I always like it when a Drow's able to come out on top, and thank you very much, Red.
I'm glad
you can keep the stereotypes going right now. Like, if you really want to do it, we're red versus blue right now.
We actually are red versus blue right now. That does work as well. Yeah.
Yeah, and we were around when that series was created. Unlike
kinda
these.
Like
oh, okay.
Pa- pa-
okay.
It's like pastely red and blue over there. I don't know what's going on.
I should have smelled that one coming from a mile away.
Mm-hmm. Love you, Nahas. Oh.
So what do you make of the draft so far, Tubby?
Nothing really surprising for me. Like, to see Team Secret pick up the Night Stalker, it's the same kind of thing the Puppy wanted to achieve with his four-position Beastmaster before. It's just this kind of, like, presence on the lane, but you know you're going to have a vision advantage more than anything else. So, like, Night Stalker will be great with that. Good you know plan. Your Darkseer is going to be stable on the lane. You've seen issues with Team Secret so far with their drafts. They want to have something really simple. If they can get that Night Stalker to a point where he can reach his Aghanim Scepter, might be difficult when the Bounty Hunter's there. Means I'm looking more towards the 4-minute rotations coming out from Secret. Who works with the Night Stalker? What's that secondary support? How does he actually find the kills and make the most of that first nighttime phase, if he can?
Mm-hmm. How difficult is it, Fogged, for Secret to ban here against Wings?
I like this, though. They're taking an approach where they take the Darkseer, they take the Night Stalker, they ban the other two offlaners that Wings really likes, the Tidehunter and the Beastmaster, so they're kind of limiting that offlane a lot for Wings, because that's pretty much
everything
that they do. It really looks like it.
It does, doesn't it?
Because the only ones that they're missing is what? Batrider offlane, Furion, and...
And maybe they're not scared of the
Broodmother? I don't know. Something like that?
Not completely out of the question that this will be a Midnight Stalker either. The Dragon Knight ban right after you pick the Night Stalker is a little bit interesting to me in that regard.
But that's also, that's a Wings hero. They love Dragon Knight. I mean, they love a million heroes, so that's kind of...
It's kind of hard to say.
So the Phoenix is going to come out second phase. No, we haven't necessarily seen that too often, but it's back again.
That's really unexpected.
Do you think
that's
a mistake from Wings, or do you think they wouldn't have expected it?
Maybe they
a mistake from Secret or
no a mistake from Wings in terms of not banning it.
Oh, not phase. Banning second phase. Yeah.
They intentionally picked the Bounty Hunter first. They kind of just left it there. So maybe they feel like it can get punished quite heavily.
Yeah. And we've seen Nyx against it today.
Yes, we have.
Yeah, we have.
And that was amazing performance.
Yeah, very effective.
Amazing performance.
And it's funny actually because I think we saw a couple of Nyx against it at Epicenter, but it wasn't really played the same way as it was played earlier
today. Yeah, and it was the big difference there, right, is that I believe all of those matchups that I saw were a support Nyx or an offlane at best. It didn't get very much. Yeah. And it makes a big difference that the Nyx was overleveled in that game.
Wings have never picked it, but I would not put it past them picking a Nyx. Like, it's extremely good versus Phoenix. I guess it's not really the best versus the Night Stalker, but it's great. It's decent versus Darkseer as well. You know, later on in the game, Mana Burn can be quite obnoxious, and Carapace on the Ion Shells.
And you got that Night Stalker mid just sitting in my head right now.
I really...
Because, like, how is Secret meant to lane this? Do you actually run a Phoenix and a Night Stalker both supports? Can you get away with that, Fogged?
It's not the most optimal, but it seems odd to do. Yeah. Well, Secret has pulled some weird stuff out in this tournament. Yeah. Like the last series, they had some like really interesting stuff that they did as well.
I mean, I think
the Kunkka. Yeah.
What we've learned in the last couple of months is that you can run a lot of support combinations if you have a good scripted set of early game rotations that you run with them, right? If you really have a great set of rotations that are going to put pressure on the opposing lanes. You know, you can make a lot of support duos work.
But with this lineup, like, you're almost running it differently. Like, you're pushing it so you run the Night Stalker and the Phoenix into, like a farm kind of role. Like, you protect your safe lane, you find more D-push than anything else and create space. Then, like, you just prioritize vision so you know where the Bounty Hunter is moving so he doesn't screw you when you're inside your jungle as well. Because like, it's just like, you can just run a straight Iron Talon Night Stalker and a Phoenix back babysitting the mid or the top lane.
This is such a Wings draft.
Your laners have to be so strong.
This is such a Wings draft.
Just Wings things. Just Wings things.
No, they really do like the second phase Slardar. I've seen them third pick Slardar in a couple games already, and it's just sort of a glue hero for their drafts. It gives them that AoE disable, gives them that way to amplify the physical damage done by the Lifestealer, gives them the vision advantage to go with the Bounty Hunter.
They may still have problems with the Phoenix, however, like, because now you're running like three melee heroes up against that Nova.
Exactly what I was about to say.
Stole that out of me. That was a really good point.
It's perfect, dude. That's actually perfect. But Slardar does give them as well an option for that Roshan, gives them a little bit more of objective-based.
Mm.
But yeah, three melee heroes running into the Phoenix can be a little bit difficult, especially because you're versus Darkseer as well.
Especially when you're blind for the last two heroes coming out of Team Secret. You're not 100% certain who you're up against here. Because like if it is just going to be that mid and the safe laner, like what do you even get? Now you also know that's like a Slardar or a Lifestealer. We go for more AoE control from the puck.
So not the Night Stalker mid. Yeah. I didn't really believe in it too much.
It didn't feel right.
Mm-hmm. Got a lot of lockdown. They are kind of lacking physical damage heavily on Secret, though. It's all pretty much magical damage at this point.
Yeah, this is feeling more and more like a single core strategy from Secret, and that's just so risky against Wings. It gets
well. It depends on the core. Like, it depends who you get up against. Like, if you actually can play Ember with vision advantage here, that's where my mind first goes here. Speak of the devil, Wings are going to pick it up. Like, you'd be able to like dodge Slaughter's initiation. The Lifestealer couldn't control you at all. Like, that would have been a great way to go, but instead, Wings, they have the Ember Spirit now.
That's it's a vehicle for the Lifestealer if they want to use it like that, which is probably something we don't really see. That's at all, but
it wouldn't be a bad combo. Catch Puck out at the right time.
Yeah, definitely catching the Puck out, because of course, you know, you can't phase shift during the Searing Chains. So that's a really interesting pick for them, just to pretty much countering the Puck. And I think Ember Spirit's quite good versus Phoenix. You can get into that back line really easily.
Mm-hmm. I'm wondering how now Team Secret round up their lineup. Because we're still looking for the EE hero. Unless EE, surprising us all, would take Nightstalker, which would probably surprise us all. How does he battle up against Ember, Slaughter, and Lifestealer? You're still running now a 4 melee lineup from Wings.
And then they're going to pick Ricky last.
Right? Oh my god.
Double infiz, mess with the Puck as much as possible.
That
nah.
Would be
can you imagine that?
It's like you got no Monkey King bar heroes as well.
I don't even want.
EE can bring up his AA can EE can bring up his PA because like there's no MKB heroes.
But look at this. It's disgusting. A measure of how
disgusting.
It's a measure of how confident Wings feel.
Wait, did they not ban?
They didn't ban.
They didn't ban.
Why did they not ban?
Mind games. This is actually a wing strategy.
They're just like, we don't care.
Wing strat.
It's either that or they maybe just ran out of time and then... This can screw up all your stats
matter,
now.
Guys. We don't care. We've got this.
Look at what they've done here. Picking an Ember into a Nightstalker, a Puck, a Darkseer. They don't care.
They don't care at all.
They genuinely don't care.
Do they Visage here?
Hello?
No, okay, they go for Destructor. Yeah. So that's pretty much first.
Yep.
That's pretty appropriate. Yeah, it's very good versus Darkseer, very good versus Puck and Phoenix.
Okay.
It doesn't give him really like a lot of gank potential amongst the lanes, however. Like, it feels like a real passive kind of thing. Like, you can counter it and maybe you can glimpse him back if you've got the vision advantage, but like, how do you rotate down to the bot lane and help Lifestealer get a kill against if like Phoenix is down there or Darkseer surges away? You have to have the vision to get the glimpse, or the levels to get the glimpse.
Yeah. I like that, though. The amp plus the glimpse. That's cool.
Mm-hmm.
It's
a nice that'll work.
Nice little cheeky combo.
Amp and track plus glimpse.
Amp and track, yeah.
Yeah.
That'll give you a vision.
Nice and cheeky. But...
Okay. About the fact that they didn't have anything like that. Perfect pick.
Yeah, I like it. He can kind of be left alone, so that we were talking about. Is the Phoenix, you know, the best being like kind of like the solo support, you could say, and he can kind of get left alone, but. Yeah.
Okay. Just before we go over to the commentators, very quickly, based on the draft, I'm going to give you the opportunity to predict the entire series. Go, Alan.
Predict the entire series?
Based on this
series?
One draft.
Yeah, because you get the draft. Normally, you have to do this before the draft. Quickly, go.
I'm going to take Wings here.
Okay.
I'm actually saying Wings, but 2-1.
Okay.
Up against Secret.
All right.
I'm going to go Secret.
Okay.
I'm believing in them.
Two for Wings, one for Secret. We gave them a little bit of a chance that time round. Let's head back to the commentary desk for game one of game three.
Our loser matchup in group number B. Letter B. Anyway, this matchup between Team Secret and Wings, obviously a lot of hopes riding on both sides. Which one of these two teams is going to end up bottom of their group? Like, we're about to see. Game kicks off.
Who will win the knife round? Who?
Oh, sorry.
Oh, man,
sorry,
I can't
wrong,
wait to
wrong
get
game,
out.
Wrong game. All right, guys. It's capitalists and gods win. What's your bets, gods? We see this draft. I like Wings. I mean, I like Wings a lot here. They were a favorite team of a lot of people here, and I like this draft from them quite a bit.
Yeah, there's a few heroes which when I see Wings get, I'm just like, okay, they're in their comfort zone. But they've also been losing with some of those. Like the Alchemist Venus, I'm like, I thought they were really going to win that game earlier today. They're going to lose it. Bounty Hunter to me is another similar pick. When I see Wings running Bounty Hunter, they just... in their zone. Like, that to me is where they're going to be able to just control the tempo of the game, dominate the early game landing stage, and really catch teams off guard.
All right, well, Secret already starting things off right. They surprise Wings with a four-man down to bottom lane. Of obviously, with the Ion Shell, it's tough to actually contest that, so Wings don't even try. And in the process, Larder was unable to pick up the top bounty rune that was being contested by Eternal Heavy. And he also took a lot of damage in return as EE just went for the spin.
Yeah, so double bounty rune, not as big as it once was with the experience changes, but still going to give a little bit of an early edge to Team Secret, specifically Artesia in this mid lane, who is going to be playing the Puck vs. Ember 1v1 matchup.
Yeah, this is going to be one of the matchups to really look out for, as well as that bottom lane where we're going to see Universe and Puppy pair up together as an aggro dual lane with the Nightstalker and Darkseer trying to put pressure on the Lifestealer as early as possible. This is one of the things I like this about the draft is that it abuses the Bounty Hunter pick quite a bit. It just means you know they're not going to have a strong, very strong safe lane, even though, yeah, Lifestealer is probably one of the better carries to match up against this. It still has an opportunity to work for Secret.
Yeah, it forces this response, which is Bounty Hunter going to be coming towards the bottom lane to effectively trial in against the dual lane, but this is just where Secret have to adjust, make sure they don't overextend in this 3v2 setup,
mm-hmm.
and try and deny as much XP as early on as possible, which they're trying to do through this pull camp.
This also means that the Slaughter is going to be matched up against dual lane of his own. A small little glimpse back, trying to get close enough to be able to get some damage on the Puppy, but he is rather tanky and he's decently fast too, so not really a problem for Secret there. The Phoenix, though, with the Juggernaut, unfortunately, they don't have a hard disable, so the Slardar should also do pretty well.
He went level one, level two bash.
If he gets another bash, this is crazy. Looks like he's just straight up got the kill with the slow. Oh, the dive! It came just a little bit too late. He finally got that level two, but half a second too late. Pylai die will be your first blood.
I mean, that's Wings in a nutshell. They just do this crazy bonkers shit that you just don't expect. Suddenly, a Slaughter right clicks you and it's like a second hit bash or something at level two. You're just like, as Pylai die there, is probably just like scratching his head like, what just happened?
I didn't expect that one, that's for sure. Especially like as against the Juggernaut, the spin, they have no disable. You naturally think, oh, he's going to have sprint because he just wants to be able to get out of range of the spin and he can play this get lane really aggressively, but no. Well, play this even more aggressively, apparently, as Slaughter is able to pick up the first kill of the game. Now we're now going to have our Bounty Hunter trying to rotate into the middle lane. There's preemptively a counter ward left in place by Arteezy, but it's on the far right side here, and it's going to take a lot of damage.
He may just get solo killed, though.
Oh, the chains goes go out. The Sunray's coming in, trying to heal him up. Arteezy just barely face shifted that one, but the Shuriken in the end will be able to finish him off, it looks like, with a dive. They'll get the counter kill, but still really important that the Ember Spirit is able to kill Artur there and reset this lane.
Yeah, the aggressive orb just allowing himself to... The Shuriken in the end needed to get the kill, but if Ember didn't kind of miss micros here, it wouldn't have been needed at all, so...
Mm-hmm.
Bit of a mistake there from Puck, who is going for an early double null build, so going for this very aggressive early game laning build, but not paying off at all.
Yeah, Arteezy really trying to punish the Ember Spirit as much as possible, but obviously that rebounds pretty heavily back onto him. The Bounty Rune picked up by Phoenix as he heads back up to the top lane, try and keep that Slardar under control, but it's just really not going to happen. As you can see, Slardar is already level 4. And does finally have a level of sprint as well as boots, so shouldn't really be much of an issue.
Yeah, with the start that Slaughter's had, he should be able to contest this lane pretty well.
Oh, nice crush, managing to catch Pylai die as well. He'll take a lot of Sunray damage, but this also means Pylai die is going to be dropping a bit low. The synergy gods of Sunray plus healing ward.
Yeah, that's the way to go. I was looking at these two heroes, and I'm like, there isn't really much synergy there. You haven't got any kind of setup from Jug to Sunray hero down, but
yeah.
I guess, like you say, you just spam that Sunray, heal him back up. Envy often goes for more points in the healing ward than a lot of Jug players.
And minute 4, Puppy thinks he can get aggressive and ice, and he might actually be right even against the Bounty Hunter who showed up. They get the glimpse back on a Universe, but they now have the Ion Shell Shuriken. Oh! Ever so barely that's enough to be able to finish him off. The Shuriken plus the right click hit of Shadow Walk. Bounty Hunter is able to finish off the Night Stalker just in time.
Yeah, that's unfortunate for Puppy, and that's the start of the night as well. So he's dead at the very start. He can immediately head back out to the lanes, but that's at least maybe a quarter of this nighttime phase wasted. So a bit of a hurt to Secret's early game. And this is not that jungle farming Nightstalker. This is just a level 3 Nightstalker who has been dual laning, mm-hmm. only has 5 CS, so it's not like he can look to he wants to get something done in this first night, even if it's just like a bit of pressure and harass here and there.
Yeah, but unfortunately, without the silence, that's going to be even more difficult. As he's just level 3. He's going to try and wrap around on mid, or maybe head up to the top lane.
Yeah, they've
caught vision of the bounty hunter, so they know Innocence is up here.
So maybe a better opportunity to try and sneak the kill mid. If he rotates top, he'll just be scouted out by the bounty hunter either way.
Yeah,
he does have dust, though. If he catches the dust at the right time, he could solo kill the bounty hunter maybe, but obviously we know that's not going to happen.
Yeah, and Blink's going to hit level 6 in this mid lane on his Ember Spirit. So the initiation potential is there. If Arteezy uses his orb, he may just get initiated on by Blink, and that's just going to be a straight up kill here. Disruptor nearby as well, so Arteezy has to play this very carefully.
Yeah, maybe the right kind of glimpse. It is only level 1. He went for the extra level in Thunderstrike, I think, in a fight. May get real quick damage on Artur. He doesn't actually immediately pop the orb, but I think he was hoping to try and bait that one out. So when Artur comes back into lane, maybe the orb is on cooldown for a few seconds, but not the case here. TZ holds on to it. The bounty rune, or the runes in general, going to be covered here by Wings. They're going to be able to pick up the bounty at top lane, regen, raiding at bottom lane.
It's definitely not great news that Secret have to spend this entire first nighttime playing passively, but at least they are getting good farm in two of the lanes with the Puck and the Juggernaut. The Darkseer is getting a bit out of the off lane plus the jungle, so it's not all bad news for them, but it's a much slower pace than we've come to expect from that four position Nightstalker. Normally it's 4 minutes in, roam around the map. You play that like that super bounty hunter almost.
And I do think that this, in fact, this is something that Charlie and I were discussing last night over dinner. The fact that we really feel like Secret, in order to succeed, have to be able to put Artur in that space-creating role, right? He can't just be more of a farmer because, you know, universes can't always be able to create all the space in the world for two different cores that are greedy as hell. So Arteezy actually playing the Puck, I think, sets Secret up for at least better opportunities than we saw in the previous series.
Yeah, and it's a hero that is also somewhat self-sufficient, at least has a way to get away from ganks, so you're not like, it's not like the supports have to commit a ton of time to babysitting him in the mid lane, making sure he has a good time.
Yeah, we can actually see that rotation coming out now. Is Secret gonna move both of their supports from top to bottom? And it looks like they will manage to catch Ice Ice. He's gonna try and dip through the trees here, gonna be attempted to run down by Universe on the Darkseer, but it's not good enough. Clean escape there, and rotation failed.
Okay, mid lane looked like there was a bit of an attempted poke from Innocence, but not even getting any damage out onto Arteezy, who has a regen rune. So very static lanes right now for Wings, especially outside of the bounty hunter, who is that kind of roaming hero. But we're not going to see a TP just yet or any kind of big move from Shadow on the Lifestealer, who's probably the big one who can make that first play should Secret go for a dive. I think that's where he's waiting for some over-aggression out of someone like Puppy on the Nightstalker.
Yeah, exactly. Especially since your offlaner is a Slardar. His timing, he peaks really, really high when he has that Blink Dagger, right? And they can have some great combos. But until then, if he really wants to get active as the Lifestealer and use some sort of Infest Bomb, it's probably going to have to be on the Ember Spirit. And I think in general, it's just Wings are going to be happy just sitting things out and biding their time, just trying to get to that 15-minute marker where I think they'll hit really strong. Arteezy coming in with the invis, is going to look for the coil and will be able to catch Ice Ice. Free kill there, but unfortunately the nature of the Lifestealer makes him too tough to gank.
Yeah, just a quick pick, not something they can transition into a tower, so not too meaningful for Secret. But it is daytime, so this is kind of the farming stage of the game for them. The one thing I don't like for Wings is something I saw in an early game with Faith Bian on the offlane for them. The Slaughter doesn't go for the Iron Talon, and I think he misses out on at least some farm because of this. There was an earlier game as well where he played Beastmaster. He went for the Quelling Blade, was jungling a little bit with his Bora, but he never actually upgrades it to Iron Talon. It's such a good item. It gives you a bit of armor, and there's really no reason not to get it.
Didn't see this one coming, the Infest into the Bounty Hunter. Forgot there was that option as well. So they may just be able to catch out the Juggernaut. It's going to need to be led with a Slytherin Crush, most likely. Otherwise, Eternal Envy is just going to be able to spin and probably run himself away.
Yeah, they know he's there, amped up, but the amp will get immediately dispelled by a Blade Fury, so going to try punish Puppy's jungle, and that's actually perhaps the much safer, reliable play to make.
Yeah. Very smart. I mean, they know Puppy's going to be jungling, they get this free kill, they could start putting some pressure on the top lane or maybe mid from there. So Wings, 4-2 now, as they poke out with their safe lane carry, and this also gives the opportunity for Disruptor, and that's another reason, right? You could say that Wings are very likely to play a lot more static in their laning phase. They've got a support there at the bottom lane that needs his level 6, so some space being bought there, but it looks like it's going to be punished almost immediately.
And at some point, they also want to get the Bounty Hunters level 6. Is where the Tomb of Experience being added did effectively give a small buff to some of these heroes like Bounty Hunter who roam around.
Ice Ice, he throws down his ultimate, manages to catch the Static Storm a little bit on RTZ, but it's actually drawing a lot of damage and may still be able to get out of here. The orb actually lands on him. The Silence finish him off. RTZ is now left with no escape mechanism except for the Surge that comes in just in time for Universe. So clean escape there, forced to TP rotation, but in the end, Wings' cores are still looking pretty decent. They're all behind the Juggernaut and the Puck, but not by much.
Yeah, and when we see the Slider Blink Dagger coming online, that's where there will be those first smoke rotations. The Ember Spirit may wait for his boot to travel, so he might try sit in a lane or tell his Slider, like, go find a kill or two without me, go with Shadow on the Lifestealer, and then I'll join up later with boot to travel, but Wings will very much up the tempo as soon as that Blink is online with Bounty Hunter's track as well.
And would you say, like, Wings is kind of like that 15-minute aggression is one of their signature styles that they're most effective at?
Absolutely. That's often, if they don't have, like, a really big laning stage advantage, and they've drafted around, like, getting a bit of an edge out of the Bounty Hunter, but Bounty Hunter is one of those heroes where you're not reliant on the early game going well. You have that kind of plan B, which is wait till that around 14, 15 minutes, you get track up, you start playing aggressive, you get kills, and you snowball out of control.
So this could be kind of the bread and butter of Wings, and with that Bounty Hunter, they should be able to have that extra bit of oomph to all of their ganks and really be able to build themselves a serious lead. And that means this is also the most critical period of time for Secret to make sure that they don't get run over. And it's also nighttime as well, so they're going to try for it. They've got a really long nighttime. They just popped the darkness. It's going to go to the 12-minute mark and go full dark for Wings.
This poor Disruptor. Every single time these ganks come his way. He's even gone Trinkle's Windlace for that extra movement speed.
This could
backfire a lot for Bounty Hunter.
Yeah.
If he's not careful.
It really could with all this smoke. They are going to bring the Ember Spirit down, and they may actually be able to pincer. Oh no, the dive away. Pilot Dive managed to get the Supernova, but immediately the pop out the Rage, and they will be able to take out the Supernova immediately. Support for support. Now they manage to get the Nightstalker as well, and Innocence will be able to get away. Universe pops the Surge and runs himself out, but I think this Ember Spirit, especially with that beautiful Blink Ford from Faithbian, will be able to catch out too. Eternal Envy's also going to fall as they just get right-clicked down by Shadow. Four down from Secret. Make it potentially five as Arteezy is going to try and jump back to his orb, but now the Slaughter is going to be able to blink forward, catching him out, manage to get the bash as well. A full wipe at 12 and a half minutes in. You couldn't have set it up any better. We said Wings, 15-minute aggression around that period of time. That's what they're best at, and we see it right there.
And they were just ready to go. The pieces just fell into place. They only had three heroes down there initially, but they were ready for that Secret movement down bottom. Something that it felt like Na'Vi took advantage of as well, just Secret perhaps going for these two predictable rotations. It's 12 minutes in, second night phase is there. You know the Puck with his newly picked up Veil wants to fight, wants to go for some aggression. Same for Puppy. He doesn't want to just sit in the jungle. He's already gotten very little out of the first night stage. It's the second one. He wants to go fight, and That lane ward bottom, yeah, it doesn't see the smoked up heroes behind, but when Universe is a solo Darkseid pushing past that ward deep near the tower, you kind of know something's a bit fishy. You're wondering, like, why is this Darkseid pushed up to our tower with no backup whatsoever when we've got Ember, Bounty, Disruptor, all these great heroes to catch him?
And Wings, not going to let up on the brakes one bit. The smoke, oh no, he just went for the blind blink in, knowing that the smoke was popped. Doesn't get anything just yet, as it looks like Wings are going to be successfully rebuffed by Secret. Ice may actually be caught out. Oh, nice, like this play. Bien actually moves over, managed to catch the Puppy Nightstalker, slowing him down with the open wounds. Will be able to get that track kill as well. That simultaneously got themselves a pickoff, a track kill, and also kind of protected Ice. If they all just retreated downriver, it might have been the Disruptor would have been the last one out and an easy pickoff for Secret instead.
Yeah, so they get Bounty's Arcane Boots off of this, and this is such a dangerous stage of the game. And that's with it being nighttime. It only gets worse as soon as we reach that next day, and Wings have such good pickoff potential. The Disruptor pickup with the Slaughter and Bounty Hunter when you have tracked and amped heroes means if you commit to a fight as Secret, you can't disengage. You are fully committed. So you have to make sure any team fight you have a you have your entire team there, and you don't, and you get the perfect initiation. Because as soon as things go badly, Wings will win. Like, they'll get a team wipe. That's what we saw at bottom. It's either all or nothing with Team Secret when you're versing a draft like this.
Oh, did he catch him? He managed to get the dust on him. The tracker is going to give him some extra movement speed. The rest of the team is close by. Two-man stun. Starting things off for the Slaughter Dart. Double Shuriken as well. The track hills are potentially there for Wings if they could just get the rest of the team into that secret shop. The lockdown puppy, get that one kill. The orb comes on through, and now the Omni Slash brings Shadow a bit low, looking for that infest out. 5 more seconds till that's up. Doesn't look like he's going to be able to make the escape. Faith BN can only do so much to be able to stall that kill. Meanwhile, the Ember Spirit does have the jump away. Shouldn't be an issue there. Jumps over behind the mid tier 1 tower, at least where it was, and TP's out successfully.
Yeah, good commitment from Secret. Once they know the bounty's there, they caught him with the dust. They commit everything. They make sure Envy's coming into the fight. They have Arteezy there as well, ready to go, and there's no half measures when you're versing Wings, so Wings perhaps bite off a bit more than they can chew at this stage, but that's not going to throw them off. If you're Wings, I think you just go, yeah, you go right back at Secret, and they're smoking before Lifestealer even respawns. He's not going to be here. He hasn't got a global TP.
This is very likely to catch Secret totally unawares. The double damage on Slardar, and even if they run into a support because they have a Bounty Hunter, this all becomes well worth it unless, oh no, the glimpse back should still be able to catch him, as I don't think Pileidai can actually get off a Supernova. That would have obviously still meant his death, so he holds on to that cooldown. Wings do get the pickoff. It is a track kill as well, which makes it all the more successful.
Yeah, this is an okay stage just to chew through smokes to find track kills, because it gives you such a good gold boost, gets you towards that mech on the Bounty Hunter, and for Wings, it's very much all-out aggression, and they can keep on doing this. They want to also fight before Arteezy gets the Blink Dagger where possible, so we'll see how much more they can do. Now that it's daytime once again, I imagine they're going to be looking to use this Bounty Hunter to try to scout out even more pickoffs.
Yeah, that is one of the things about this new build on the Puck. It does offer some better times going, you know, 25 minutes, you actually hit really hard, you have all this mobility, but in this weird period of time where you have the Veil but you don't have the Blink, it's actually something that teams may be able to take advantage of now. Obviously, we saw earlier, they spotted out that ward placement from the Bounty Hunter, but it's top lane where Secret may be trapped like rats. Puppy does not have a TP out, and he's going to start Iron Taloning his way out to freedom.
Teams are just getting so much better at using scans. We see a scan onto the tier 2, basically trying to see, okay, is someone either retreating from the tier 1 or coming to back up to defend this tower? And they did get vision of something, so Innocence is already trying to see exactly what they saw, and Puppy may get caught out as a result.
Yeah, he sees it. The sprint is activated. Slaughter is going to be able to catch up in another track kill and maybe a forced TP. That's actually going to be completed by Arteezy. He thinks he's going to be able to get the Bounty Hunter, but
I think Phoenix is dust.
Vision? Yeah, I'm sure it's going to be coming in. Counter ward laid out, but it's a little bit too late. Now the rest of Wings are going to be able to jump in. Pileye Die taken out before the Supernova, and that's big, even as the orb comes through from Arteezy, and he does a lot of damage. He's now left stranded underneath this tier 2 tower as Wings surrounding, hoping to be able to take out this mid player, and it shouldn't really be an issue. Chain stun, and with that amp damage, with the Lifestealer as well, who's got an armlet, as well as an Echo Saber already. The damage is too much for Arteezy to be able to roar. And now Eternal Envy might actually be taking too much as he goes for a spin.
Gosh,
what
no
is
TP.
Happening?
He went greedy for the tower. Like, okay, I'm going to Blade Fury the tower. It gets denied. And then on top of that, Shadow's like, oh, I also got your kill. So this is like just a tilt, like more than anything. Yeah. Like, I mean, Secret just got 2-0'd by Na'Vi. They're going to go into the next series. And this is the kind of drop which will, like, kind of really just mentally challenge you as well, because it's so aggressive. You give up a couple kills, you know it's track money, and you know they're going to just keep coming at you and continue to fight. So if you're not playing, like, perfect polished Dota, this drop will get one kill a minute, and we're almost at that point for Wings.
Ever since that bottom fight, Secret have always been on the back foot, and I don't think they pretty much after that bottom fight, I don't think they were ever really in a position to be able to five-man and fight Wings ever again, because you just know you're, even if you kind of do okay in that fight, you're going to trade off track kills. So now it's just left, okay, try and push this game a little bit later, which is Secret, something that Secret usually like to be able to do, but they don't even have the Battle Fury yet on Juggernaut, which means he's just inevitably going to fall way too far behind. And
I don't think they've got the late games really full back on either. Not with like a Dux. They've got the team fight in the late game, but they haven't got the carries to scale in the late game.
Yeah,
Nightstalker's
exactly.
Not close to an Ag Scepter. Jug can kind of scale well, but he's versing like 2 to 3 core heroes when you look at what Slaughter, Ember, and Lifesteal. These are all pretty good late game cores.
Oh, an Eternal Envy not going to be quick enough on the fingers. The Slithering Crush locks him down. Lifestealer takes him out. And now it's time for Wings to just enjoy the spoils of victory. They can back out, farm away. As you said, they've got very clearly the cores to be able to take late game with both Ember Spirit and Lifestealer. And we're talking about late game like it's something that we may actually see. But 20 minutes in, this is looking like a game that Wings is just going to roll over Secret and win by 30.
That's the thing. You get to 25 minutes in, what's currently a 7.5k goal, it gets to 10k. They're just going to look to keep on increasing this lead. And you're going to get to maybe 30 minutes in where you're ready to end the game because you've got 15k gold lead. You've kept finding more track kills. You've continued to just farm your way to a first Roche and a second Roche. They can take Roche whenever they want. I think more than anything, they're just like, well, taking Roche is time where we could be pressuring Secret, taking towers, getting kills. So we're just going to wait a little bit and go for Roche later.
Yeah, and this is probably a big part of the reason why Wings were willing to blow smoke after smoke after smoke, right? They knew Secret had to be able to do well in that 15 to 20 minute marker. And if Wings actually rolled over in that period of time, well, there's not much Secret can really do. Eternal Envy isn't farmed enough that he's not going to be a threat at 25 or 30 minutes without a Battle Fury picked up early, and they obviously have the late game to be able to fall back on as well as for Wings, so they throw everything into those periods of time, play ultra aggressive, get the pickoffs they need, and now going to be able to look to go all the more. Puppy's going to be the first target here. They managed to get a decent jump there from Arteezy, but it's just not enough. Now, bringing him back right into the Static Storm. He's able to get the jump away with the phase shift combination. Beautiful play from Arteezy, but again, is it really going to be enough? The Supernova way in the back line, and actually, Secret may have just lured Wings into a bad position with the Omni Slash going down. They actually do get the Lifestealer. Oh man, Secret punishing now as Arteezy's gonna jump in for more, but a two-man crush. Oh no, Secret, are you the ones who went a little bit too far? Phase shift only gonna last so long, and Arteezy is gonna be left out to dry. Another track kill going the way of Wings, just as you think. Secret have a small opening to be able to get something back for themselves. They still feed away another track kill.
Yeah, I guess Arteezy did have his blink completed. They're not done yet though. Secret thinking about defending the tier one, but they've got to act quickly if that's the case, and it doesn't look like they've got the tools to do so. All their ulties on cooldown, so they committed pretty much everything. They get a lifesteal, which is a high-value pickup, but Wings get an objective. They continue to have momentum in their favor as well, and with this T1 bottom tower down, taking Roshan now gets that much easier.
Blink dagger for Ice Ice, a disruptor with a 22-minute blink dagger. That's definitely a scary thought.
And not your everyday disruptor item, but this item gets so much better because they've got the vision tools in Bounty Hunter and Slaughter with their ultimates. So being able to reposition and catch those here, get that little bit closer to get those glimpses off becomes that much more powerful.
Wings. Four man in mid, one at top. Ember Spirit is free to pretty much do as he likes, just because Secret have been pushed back so far that it's unlikely for them to ever be able to get in an aggressive stance. They're going to be able to go for another smoke, wrap around behind the tier 2 at top, or maybe the tier 2 mid. They cut between the tier 3s.
The slot has picked up a Reva of all items. Second item Reva.
Jesus.
I've never seen anything like that. Perhaps Wings have done it before, but
if he gets a heart early, how do you even deal with that? Like, Secret actually may not have the damage to be able to pop that hero, which normally you can, right? Because Sprint amplifies that damage. You're relying on that mobility. Oh no, it's her Levy. He thinks this is an opportunity to be able to farm the stack, but he's gone already. Can't even call it fast enough. The Ember Spirit now with the Battle Fury is going to be able to take that stack. And what little hope there was remaining for Secret, I think, just got extinguished with that stack.
That was a crazy good smoke from Wings. They got themselves in position where they could use the Observer Ward, scouting out the Ancients area. They bypassed the Secret vision around the Roshan pit, and they have a pretty good idea that Secret aren't going to... They knew Secret didn't have a ward on top of theirs with their sentry, so there's not going to be any vision over where that T1 bottom tower normally is.
Oh, crazy play here. Supernova going out of the side, but Arteezy does manage to get silenced up before he can do much there. Great Static Storm from Ice Ice, and now Pilot die. Refreshed up, does manage.
Glimpse.
Oh, he's got the glimpse. He's got it in play. Pilot Eye is going to be pulled back right into both the end well as Blink.
That's almost like the game right there. Yeah. They're not going to quite call it with the tier 2 tower still up, but that's that YOLO all in. Let's try and contest Roshan, and you just give them multiple track kills. You lose your mid puck, you lose Aegis, and Wings get even further ahead.
Yeah, you know if you're Secret, you had to do something desperate, and that was definitely the desperate play, but it doesn't work out for them. The Blink Dagger now up for Blink. We saw that one earlier. And he already has another 1,600 gold.
Interesting to see the pipe over the mech, but a very good item against the Puck who has built into the Veil. It's going to give some great just self-sustainability, but also, more importantly, the teamfight factor, where his whole team can block a lot of that Puck damage output.
Yeah, and give them opportunities to push high ground a lot earlier. Being able to keep those creeps alive against the Veil spam.
Yeah, that's absolutely correct.
With the Tessellator, they can actually challenge some of these Tier 2s and even Tier 3s rather early on, just considering how far ahead they really are. Looks like they may have found another one here on the left-hand side. We're going to see Eternal Envy. He's going to be Static Stormed immediately. Good combo. Ice, once again, showing off that Blink Dagger with the instant disables on some of these heroes that usually have some great defense mechanisms, the Puck as well as the Juggernaut, but the Disruptor that's this far ahead is punishing them.
Yeah, you think of a Jug kind of farming alone there, as long as he can Blade Fury TP away, the one thing that could catch him by surprise is the Slaughter, who's not there, but Link Static Storm also does the trick, and Wings now should find themselves a free Tier 2 tower up top. I don't really feel it's the time for Secret to fight right now. They're against an Aegis. High ground is going to be your best bet, but Wings, if you stay on your high ground, Wings can always just kind of play the slow roll game. Just maintain map control, deward the entire map, farm your jungle, farm their side of the map, farm your side of the map, and just get further and further ahead.
Yeah, what we're really going to see here in the next few minutes is more about Wings than anything else. It's going to be how patient and how disciplined they really want to be in this kind of match, where they very clearly have a gigantic lead. And they could potentially end the game right here in the next 5 minutes, but it does come at a small risk. Very small, but they could keep that risk even smaller if they just spend more time out farming Secret.
And every play Secret's making, it feels like a desperation play. The Roche contest, now they're going to go for a four-man smoke, sit behind Eternal Envy. It's kind of like these desperation smokes that you're just hoping gets yourself in a good position to take a team fight, but realistically, Wings aren't having any of this.
Maybe they can get the Ember Spirit, the Blink forward from Arteezy, leading with a Silence. Could have caught out Blink. They may still inside the trees. Nope. Got out in time.
Cool.
Close, and I believe nighttime. Okay, so we'll be coming back around the 28-minute mark, but it's Wings who are going to cut off the retreat.
Yeah, they're going to be able to catch Secret now, running back downwards, maybe realizing that they're trapped on the enemy side of the base. Pylai Dai is going to be spotted out here, does have the dive, tries to get away, has track on himself. Just don't think that's going to happen, not with the Disruptor on the team. Another track kill for Wings.
And this is starting to add up. The gem is there for Wings, so they can take out all the vision of Team Secret. And it's just one out of tower off the other. So it seems like, I'm about to say mid lane, they've just dived the high ground. I was about to say, It seems like Wings are taking this slow, but no, they're ready to dive.
They take one, make it two, as Puffy's also going to go down. Arteezy can't really stop him with the Dream Coil. They glimpse back Arteezy, face shift, blink out, he'll be okay, but only for a few minutes, it seems, as Wings are just not going to give Secret any room. I mean, this is game number one. Maybe Wings going for a psychological play, trying to break their spirit as soon as possible in this series by ending the game outright.
And the Slaughter with the Heart literally just blind blinked onto the high ground of a Tier 3 tower and found a crush. And he's like, oh, sweet, that's a kill. I'll take it.
Yeah. And with the Heart, you can make those kind of plays fearlessly, knowing that Secret just do not have the damage to eat through you fast enough. The Lifestealer inside, they can't challenge you either. There goes the lane of Rax. Wings, happy with the pickoff. We'll start backing up. Phoenix, I think, hoping to be able to draw Wings back inside, as that's really the only way. Oh, Vice jumps in. Okay, not being able to get that kinetic field, forcing out the supernova. And okay, now let's really call it a day. Wings will back themselves away. Double chain, never mind. Jump back in, Bian. Missing the crush. The pipe is going to be able to keep them protected a little bit. Secret.
It's strange because it keeps feeling like, okay, time to back off Wings. Yeah. Like, you just lost your Aegis, you just wasted time.
Oh, no, another two-man crush. They're just like, we're so far ahead, let's keep on going.
Yeah.
Underneath Tier 4 towers.
I mean, most of the time, you waste Static Storm and Aegis, you have to back off, but as you said, too far ahead.
And now the jump in, two-man crush once again with the Lifestealer popping out already. Eternal Envy's gone. No Omni-Slash opportunities, that's it. Puppy's calling it. The leader says this is not good.
Classic Wings Gaming, a kill a minute, aggression, They start off maybe a bit slower in the laning stage, but once they get going, boy, do they get going. And this is why, like, the Bounty Hunter is just one of those most banned heroes when you're versing Winx, because their mid-game with Bounty is just scary.
I'm not sure what other way to really...